thank you for joining us on Pachter Factor, my fellow babies, on sifted.net. If you're a Patreon patron or a YouTube subscriber, we are getting paid. Thank you very much. Another easy way to make sure that Shane gets to cover his expenses for producing this show, try to link your Amazon Prime account to your Twitch Prime account, and we get paid. The instructions are real right there in the show description below. Super easy to do, so please do that if you or your family members have an Amazon Prime account. Super easy to do. If you don't do any of those things, you're watching on YouTube a week late. That's the price you have to pay for not having any money, but that's okay. Save up. It's $2 a month on Patreon. I'm sure you can afford it. Today's question from Sifted from Backby. After the success of The Last of Us on HBO, and spoilers, because I've seen it, what other gaming properties would you like to see to be turned into a TV show or film? Can you see a GTA movie now being a possibility, even though the Hauser brothers stopped it in the early 2000s? You know, the problem I see with television is that game stories tend not to be that good. So, spoiler alert, if you haven't seen Last of Us, turn off this episode, please, because I'm going to tell you what happens in the show. But, so, please don't watch the rest of this episode if you haven't seen the Last of Us TV show. But if you play the game, you totally know what happens. So, when you played the Last of Us game, I don't think I realized how good a story it was until I got to the end, right? So, I've got Joel, he loses his daughter. He adopts Ellie, whatever, becomes her guardian, and then is given this assignment. She's going to save mankind if he gets her across the country and goes through all these zombies and raiders. And I don't think they're zombies, but whatever they are, the infected. And when you get to the end, and he finds out that they have to sacrifice her to come up with a cure, he goes berserk and he kills everybody because he's kind of identified with her as his daughter. And it's really cool. And I didn't realize how good a story it was until the end. So throughout the story, it was just like, I didn't care. It was just like, okay, your mission is to protect this girl. It was no, and honestly, in the game, had she died, I think I probably would have been okay, you know, because I would have thought that was part of the game. But she doesn't, and it is your job to keep her alive at all costs, and she does save your life if you're playing Joel. She has NPC, or you can take over. The game was very well constructed, but I didn't care about the story till the very end, and then I went, oh, that's really clever. Like, that was good. Now, they made Uncharted, same writers. I mean, Amy Hennig was the initial writer on Uncharted, but Neil Druckmann was Uncharted as well. And they made that in a movie. It was actually pretty good. TV show, no chance. Movie, pretty good. Like, it actually worked because it was fun. It was like James Bond. It was like an adventure, 2 hours, it's over. It was, you had a good time. I think most games that are story-driven work as movies. A game as a TV show, I think it's hard to pull out the drama. I think it's hard to make it where you actually care about the characters. So again, spoiler alert for Last of Us. Episode 3 or 5, I think it was 5. I forgot the guys' names, but Frank and whatever. There were two guys that are not major important characters in either the game or the TV show, but they divert to these guys and how one of them's a survivalist who kind of arms everybody and supplies everybody with what they need, and the other guy was gay and they became gay lovers and they die together. And it was a very touching episode. And it really didn't have anything to do with the plot at all. Like, I actually wondered in the show, are they going to come back to that? Because the story of the two guys literally went 20 years. It was like, here's when they met in 2003, and here's when they died in 2023. And I thought we'd come back to them in 2021 or two, and we didn't. You know, maybe they will next season. But it was just an interesting diversion that's something when I play a game, I would never go, oh, they should do a full episode of a TV show about this character that just died. Like, you wouldn't think about that. So, you know, I think that it's, the reason I brought that up is, it's the creativity of Neil Druckmann, it's the skill of Neil Druckmann to pull that out of his creation and highlight some characters that are really interesting that really didn't have the full backstory in the game and didn't matter in the game, but they mattered, you know, a lot in the show. But I think more just to make a social statement, and an interesting social statement that, you know, that when you love somebody, you're willing to die for them, and that was cool. It was a really well done thing. So creating television that's compelling and makes you want to tune in every week is hard. I think it's really, really hard. And I don't think short form video game, you know, 10-hour games lend themselves to TV series. I think they lend themselves to 2-hour movies. So, you know, they did a World of Warcraft movie. It was fair. You know, they could do they could probably try to do a TV show out of it. No one would care. You need a recurring theme and you need cliffhangers. And, you know, so if you watch The Last of Us TV series, it actually followed the games, number one, very well. And it ends when number one ends. And Last of Us 2 is going to pick up, season 2 is going to pick up where 2 started. But you can go 3 or 4 or 5 more years. I mean, it's like Walking Dead. I mean, you can keep finding reasons to you know, fight raiders. And I think they set up very well. He's going back to be with his brother, you know, so you'll be back in a community and you can fight off the raiders. I'm sure they can modify the story to have her blood become some type of a, you know, antibody or antidote for infection. But it's rare that you can get a TV show. Movies, yes. And I think that the Mario movie really is proving that out. We've always had game movies. Lara Croft, Resident Evil have always worked pretty well. I thought the most recent Mortal Kombat was actually pretty good. It just really takes the right property. And you know, the thing about games is that, as Shane pointed out, Breath of the Wild sold like 20 million units. So are you going to make a movie out of Breath of the Wild? Probably not. But how many copies cumulatively has Mario sold in all the various Mario games? A couple hundred million, easy. And that means a couple hundred million people know who Mario is. More likely, 500 million people know who Mario is. And after this movie, 1 billion. You know, so it's good branding. I think that Disney is the master at taking intellectual property and figuring out whether to make a movie or a TV show. They took, like, Loki, a character from a movie, and they gave him a TV series, and it was so good, I think they make a Loki movie. You know, so they go back and forth, Marvel, Mrs. Marvel. You know, they're really smart about that. But it's a real fine skill to make a recurring theme TV show. It's really hard to keep people coming back, as opposed to a movie, which is a self-contained story, beginning, middle, end, like most games. Most single-player games, beginning, middle, end, you finish the game, you're done. So I think you'll see a lot more video game movies. I think it will be rare that you see a video game TV series, and Last of Us, I think, is the exception that proves that rule. Game properties that I think would be fun movies, any story driven. So Elder Scrolls would work. GTA would work. I mean, you can make GTA the movie. They've done Max Payne, you know, it was okay. But I don't think that the property was popular enough. GTA is. I could see you doing Call of Duty the movie. I mean, you absolutely could. I think pretty much any military type shooter, Halo, they made a movie out of. Or they're making, Halo, they're doing a TV series. Yeah, yeah. I mean, obviously, the bigger the property, the more popular the game, the better chance, just because of brand recognition. But I mean, I don't think you could do a movie out of Fortnite. I don't think that'd be fun. Could you do a movie out of Apex? Maybe. Like, the more complex the characters and the character development. I mean, I think of Apex more like X-Men, and I think of Fortnite more like regular people. You know, so the more the skill set, like Overwatch is a movie, maybe. I think what Illumination's version of Mario proves is you can do really good looking animation that looks like the game and makes it really fun. So Borderlands, they're making a movie. That I think the Borderlands movie will work. Like that, I think will be good. You know, because again, it's that kind of story. It's like a story makes sense in a closed setting. Fallout would be a great movie. Probably not a good TV series, but good movie. And I'm sure that'll happen eventually. The GTA stories are a little odd, and there's no point. Like, when you play GTA, I mean, I've never finished one, so I shouldn't say that. I don't know. How do they end? Do they end good?
Or do they end? Depends on the game.
But do they end like you accomplish anything, or you just
usually kinda, most people are dead and you're like the last one standing
and you ran all the missions, but there's no point. Like, I don't really get the point of GTA. I always get bored after about 75 missions and I just don't finish them. Where Red Dead I finished, like, that was worth finishing. That would probably be a good movie. So sure, yes, you can. I think Rockstar stuff you could make movies out of. TV series, I can't think of any. Thanks for joining us on Pachter Factor on SIFTD.net, and to our Patreon patrons and our YouTube subscribers and our Twitch Prime members who managed to figure out how to link their Amazon Prime account, instructions below. Thank you, because we're getting paid and Shane can afford to continue to come out here and make these things. If you are neither a Patreon nor a YouTube subscriber and you are too lame or don't have Amazon Prime, too lame to figure out how to link it, please follow me on Twitter as penance for your sins at Michael Pachter. You're watching on YouTube a week late, but let me know on Twitter that I shamed you into it, and I will give you a shout out. Thank you for following me, and thanks for joining us. We'll see you next time.